Welcome to this module of the Massive Open Online Course, or MOOC, IB6143. Today I will introduce you to genome sequencing, or DNA sequencing, from a historical perspective. We are now at the genome sequencing facility at University of Malaysia, Sabah, and we have a collection of sequences which illustrate the evolution of DNA sequencing as it has evolved over the past decades. So early sequencing commenced with what are known as the Sanger sequences. So we have an ABI sequence over here, which is basically based on the principle of dideoxytermination. Now Sanger sequences were very accurate. However, they have a very low throughput, which means the yield of data is low. So we can go in for maybe 90 or 100 sequences based on the format which is used, and that's about it. So these sequences have a limitation in terms of the data which they can produce. So step back or step forward to the next generation sequences. This is an Illumina MiSeq. This sequencer is based on short reads. So it will basically use either a paired end read, which is a short fragment of DNA, and it will then assemble these short fragments of DNA into the entire genome. So this is something like a jigsaw puzzle. So what we do when we operate this sequencer is basically take a genome, a bacterial genome, because this sequencer is designed for small genomes. The bacterial genome is then sheared or cut into blocks of around 150 to 250 bases. These short reads of DNA are then ligated onto adapters which have unique DNA codes or indexes. And this entire mixture is added to the sequencing flow cell, and the sequencer will then read individual DNA fragments and it will produce data. Now the advantage of this sequencing technology is that you can sequence entire genomes of or entire prokaryotic genome in a very short duration of time. And this sequencing technology has basically evolved because of the development of computational power. Today, a large amount of DNA sequencing or a large amount of data is available because we have advantages of computational power. The MiSeq is ideal for small genomes, small bacterial genomes or small transcriptomes. It is also used for metagenomics. The next level of sequencing technology which we have over here is the single molecule real-time sequencing machine. So this is the single molecule real-time sequencer, which is from Pacific Biosciences. This yields significantly longer reads as well as higher quality data. So with this sequencer, it is now possible to sequence large eukaryotic genomes in a short duration of time. So this lab illustrates the evolution of genome sequencing technology, which commenced with the basic DNA sequences, then evolved into the next generation sequences such as the MiSeq and HiSeq from Illumina. And finally, we have today's most advanced machines, which are the Pacific Biosciences RS2, which is based on single molecule real-time sequencing technology. Now this short overview has to be viewed in conjunction with your module, which will provide you more insights into the evolution of DNA sequencing technology. Thank you for watching.